Morning, everyone. Monday, the 3rd of April, 2023. Hope you're doing well. Just getting over this cold. Girlfriend's got the cold, too, right now, so it's going to be a pretty subdued week. Don't know if I'm going to have a show on Wednesday, so I wanted to make this one now. Timings are really going to be screwed up. Distraction. Just want to talk about quick distraction. I noticed that the Trump thing is getting a lot of traction. Distraction. And the Posey Parker, Kelly J. Keen debacle situation in New Zealand is getting a lot of traction. And not so much in the mainstream, but very much so in the alternative press. And I think that the whole reason behind it is, and once again, I'll say this, it's just to get your hackles up. Also, just another distractionary thing is the Dan Dix Press for Truth when he was at, I think it was this week or this weekend or something, but, you know, another protest somewhere in Vancouver, and, you know, there was some shenanigans. But what it is that all of these videos, all of them, are fomenting discord. That's all they're doing. They're not solving any problems. Like, if you really think that deluded men who are confused and attack a young, middle-aged lady, you know, trying to advocate for safe spaces for women is okay. Like, if you can't see that that's just completely driving a wedge in society, you know, like, you look at the Trump thing, because what you've got is, in the alternative media, is you've got, you know, the narratives on both sides. You've got the mainstream narrative, which is just complete and utter horseshit anyway. Like, you've got to sift through mainstream narratives to figure out what's going on in there. But we've got many alternative narratives as well. And some of the alternative narratives will go with the mainstream narrative to some degree. And all it is doing in the world out there, outside of the world of MSM prostitute whore media, is dividing people and getting them really pissed off. Like, when you see an injustice happen, when you perceive something as a wrong, like you see a woman getting beat up by a man, and you don't see anything happen because of it, you get upset. You see somebody be arrested on false charges, allegedly, supposedly, whatever, and you get upset, frustration. You can see it in a normal civilian's eyes when, you know, there's a myriad of cop videos out there where the person's innocent and the cop's giving them the rigmarole, and, you know, you get the auditors, and then they're grading the performance of everything, but the frustration is there. It's there. You can see it in their face now. It's evident, and it comes out right away in that video because, you know, the cops are doing something wrong or whatever. You know, they're arresting him for speeding, and he wasn't speeding, whatever, or her, or whatever. But the other videos, you know, it's not so obvious. It's not so obvious. Like, you see it happen, and then you're, like, wondering, well, something will come of it later. You know, we're good people. Good things happen to good, you know, like this kind of thing, that justice will be served, you know, trust in your system, you know, but it's not working. And if anything, the distractions are just there to foment. That's it. That's all it's designed to do. It has no basis in reality, you know. It is a distraction, yes, but it is an absolute thing to make it worse. And it's making it worse and worse and worse by the day. Because nothing comes of it. And it's going to get much worse. In order to implement whatever control grid that's going to have to be implemented, you're going to have to get the populace to the point where they're inviting rule. when they're inviting oppression, you know. If in that video alone, and I'm not a fan of Dan Dix. I'm not a Press for Truth guy. I'm just saying what was out there. If that wasn't designed, you know, because nothing's going to come of the officer who did nothing and laughed and thought it was funny and let somebody be assaulted, you know, nothing's going to come of it. Nothing's going to come of the Kelly J. Keene thing. Nothing is going to come from the Trump thing except for fomenting discord among the people. The same thing with the trucker protest hearing. Nothing came of it. The same thing with this silly RCMP paper came out saying about the Nova Scotia shooter, you know, which is suspect anyway. But all it did was just enough to get people at each other to the point where as it gets worse and worse and worse, and you perceive your truth and they perceive their truth, that we're at each other to the point where that the 20% or whatever that are completely mainstream, but please bring it all, bring the martial law, bring this, bring that, bring the other, so I can go to curling, so I can go to golf, so I can go to my concert, so I can go to my movie, so I can go to my football game, so I can go to my baseball game, so I can go to my NASCAR race. That is all the distraction is doing right now, because nothing's coming of it. Nothing's being solved. Nothing has been solved. There's a lot of money out there. There's a lot of money that's able to manipulate the narrative. We know that. And we are being guided, in my opinion, down the path. And in my opinion, it's going to get much worse as the distractions come more and more heavy, because that's what they are. It's put out there, tastes great, less filling, you know. Bud Light or whatever made the commercial, you know, two idiots sitting with two beer, and one said tastes great and the other one went less filling, and it's been an argument ever since. And I'm joking, of course, because who gives a shit, really? They're both shit beer, you know, light beer is shit beer. Light beer, alcoholless beer, you know, really? Anyway, I'm on a tangent, because I've just been watching over the weekend, right, and just trying to figure out some stuff. The weather's going crazy. We're supposed to get snow today. It's April 3rd. It's supposed to drop down for snow. The weather's crazy. Nobody can even argue. We're arguing about the weather, you know. My girlfriend and I did not have COVID. I had a lung butter sinus infection, and I'm going to attribute it to, because the way of the world is so stupid. Instead of using salt to melt the ice and snow in the winter, now all they do is they pour rocks and mud and dirt on the road to make slurry, because it doesn't do anything. I know salt isn't good for the environment. Just going to shut the door. Hang on a sec. Cat just came in. I know salt isn't good for the environment, but I don't give a shit because I don't put it on my garden, and realistically, in any highway system, depending on the environment, you know, 50 yards on each side of the road should be a no-go zone, you know, dead zone or whatever, you know, whatever, what have you, so that, because we need the roads to be clear. All that's happening right now is they've put dirt and rocks in the road, and while it might work for a brief moment, it doesn't work at all. And all it does for the spring is, like, right now on the highway right there, when the cars go by fast enough, there's just dirt devils and just big plofs of poofs of dust and shit. So, and when I have, this is another thing where we're pitted against each other. When we talk about this, salt, no salt. This is where we are. Salt, no salt. Good for the environment, not good for the environment. You see, everything is pitted. But it doesn't work. But nobody cares. And you are, oh, well, it doesn't work after minus 27. Really? Okay. I'll argue that point. So we don't use it in the north. It doesn't get to minus 27 here. And you know, we had those days when it was like really, 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 really cold. Minus 18. Ooh. salt works when it's cold like that. So, you know, I'm sorry, that's such a stupid example. Like, you know, such a stupid thing to bitch about. But it's another thing. It's like, you know, here, we'll make up something that'll possibly be better for the environment, and it won't work, but fuck it. Somebody's going to get, the windshield company will get new windshields every year because we're throwing rocks all over the road. Just pisses people off. Because guys my age, who've been driving in the ice and the snow and the north and everything all their life on salt because we didn't give a shit. We used to use salt like going out of style back in the day when we were plowing Montreal. Man, your salt buds would be so nasty. And usually you'd be out of it within the first couple months anyway, but it works. Rocks and dirt do not work. All it does is make an unholy mess. And right now, like, you know, if I were to sweep up my sidewalk and in front of my house, I'd get like, you know, 6 or 7 wheelbarrows full of shit. So, you know, anyway. It's just a thing. It's just a more of a, you know, as the fantastical model of the world goes forward, you know, the one that not many people partake in, the rest of the non-fantastical world is burning. So, and in order for them to, so they can have their gold toilets and everything, you have to pit each other against, you have to pit us against each other. So that's the way it's going. So that's what I'm, that's all I wanted to talk about really right now, about the Kelly J. Keene, the, you know, the cop protest, and, or not the cop protest, but the protest with Press for Truth. There's a video out of it. You know, the cop is just like completely lying, and anyway, but it's designed for that. It's designed for that. And if I can say anything, and myself included, it has been part of that, that the alternative media, we've been not co-opted, but like we've been manipulated into a role of we're the other side of the story to foment, so that we're getting, you know, like there's people that are like-minded that who think like I do, who are pissed off because, you know, whatever happened in New Zealand or whatever happened in Vancouver or whatever happened with, repeat offenders, you know, stuff like that. And then you get the other side. See, so like we all fit into our role. I don't know where it's going to end, because we're at a fever pitch right now, and I think it's going to get much, much worse. Because this model, whatever this model is, whatever model this we're following, is not functioning as designed. There's too much inequity in the world. You know, I don't have the answer, right? But I know that this model is not functioning as designed. And if it is functioning, it's functioning on a level that it's so unfair that it's functioning at an unfair, like, you know, people are like, well, it's the best of the worst models. Does that make any sense? It's the best of the worst. You know, oh, we tried we tried this, the medieval times weren't that really good, you know, we tried this system, you know, the Mongols tried their system, the Romans tried their system, you know, and now we've got all these systems going on in some sort of model that is not functioning. There's no unity, there's no coming together in common cause, so. But anyway, just speaking to what the topic of the video was, the distraction, the fomenting of discord, the roles that we've been pushed into, the and it's by design, it's going to get worse, because it's much easier to have us neighbors fighting each other, right? But I just want to leave you with one thought before I don't know how to say this without getting banned or whatever. This is a really hard one, but you need to really think hard and heavy on who the real enemy is. We need to think hard and heavy on keeping our gray matter packed. We can't lose our shit. Like, if you become our incarcerator, or become part of that shitty model system that's going on right now, you may not be able to extricate yourself from that system. You know, if you become involved in the legal, the judicial, you know, if they are starting to come out, like if you become identifiable in the Matrix, then you are identifiable in the matrix, and that's where it starts, and then it could either grow or get where, I don't know. But what do we used to say in the military? We'd be sucked back and reload, you know, reevaluate, reassess the battle plan. We're being played for suckers, so the fact that your neighbor doesn't think like you, he is not the problem. There's a myriad of videos explaining that right now, and that's what I noticed over the weekend. You know, I'm sorry, you know, like, if what happened in New Zealand isn't obvious, and just a small example of what happened in Vancouver over the weekend, you know, and just very small examples, you know. I mean, I've read both sides of the Trump case, too, and I'm like, oh, okay, this should not be going forward. So this is going on for a reason. And I think we identified the reason. So I was convinced that today would have been a bank holiday. I was convinced that April 1 would have been something. I was wrong, of course, as I am a lot. But I think that was just a stay of execution. That's all I think that that was. I think that we just had a stay, that somebody did something, because the market's up again this morning. I thought it would, you know, would have been down a bit. But I think it's another one of these just like last minute things. People saying this is the summer, you know, this is the one. We see what's going on in the U and the R. We see some shenanigans going on over there. You get a lot of backdoor stuff, so anything can happen. Keep your shit packed. Identify who the enemy is. He's not your neighbor. He is not your neighbor. If anything, my worst enemy is my brain. You know, because I just get thinking and stuff, and especially if you get down those rabbit holes, so be very careful. So, anyway, I'm not going to be in the garden today, that's for sure. And I did see some snowflakes. We'll see what happens. But anyway, peace to you and yours. That's all I want. We'll see for a show Wednesday. Check by like around 11 o'clock. You know, if I'm not on, like usually I'm there 2 minutes before or something like that. If it's not happening, it's not happening. We have to go to the big city, and my girlfriend's got to get some injections in her knee, and there's a lot of life intruding this week, so we'll see what we can do. But no promises for Wednesday, but if I'm here, I'm here, and we'll talk about a lot of things. Okay? Peace to you and yours. Keep your gray matter packed. Talk to you on the flip side.